Muhammad Yunis al Ahmed al Muwali, Arabic. Arabic letter meme, Arabic letter ha, Arabic letter meme, Arabic letter dal, Arabic letter ye, Arabic letter wa, Arabic letter noon, Arabic letter seen, Arabic letter aleph, Arabic letter lam, Arabic letter aleph with amza above, Arabic letter ha, Arabic letter meme, Arabic letter dal, aka Qadr al-Sabahi is a former senior member of the Iraqi Baath party. Ahmed currently has a $1 million bounty placed on his head as one of Iraq's most wanted men accused of funding and leading resistance operations. He is the leader of Al-Ada, an underground Ba'athist movement in Iraq. Early life and career in Ba'athist Iraq. Ahmed was born in 1949 in Al-Mawal in the Kingdom of Iraq's Mosul province, and rose in the ranks of the Iraqi Ba'ath party under the rule of Saddam Hussein, initially serving in the Iraqi Army's Political Guidance Directorate, which was tasked with ensuring Ba'athist control of the military. Ahmed later became a senior member of the party's military bureau. Though part of the Ba'ath party's supreme command by the time of the 2003 invasion of Iraq, the United States did not prioritize his capture until months after the fall of the Ba'athist government, inadvertently giving Ahmed enough time to go into hiding. Iraqi insurgency. Former aide to former president of Iraq and leader Saddam Hussein and a regional Ba'ath party organizer who it appears was trained in Moscow. Following the 2003 Iraq war, he was allegedly one of the leading figures among the Iraqi insurgency and a major rival to Izzat Ibrahim al-Duhuri. By 2006, the Iraqi government alleged he was a operational leader, financial facilitator and field commander of the Ba'athist insurgents. Largely based in Syria since the war, Yunis was accused by Iraqi President Nouri al-Maliki of having access to substantial funds and that he has been dispersing funds and directing fighting of Sunni insurgents inside Iraq. According to journalists Michael Weiss and Hassan Hassan, Syrian President Bashar al-Assad attempted to make al-Ahmed the leader of the Iraqi Ba'athist insurgents at some point. However, others reported that his organization, Al-Ada, has many Shiites in the middle level and is attractive to some former Ba'athist Shiites from southern Iraq, and it is believed that Shiite followers of Yunis are active in southern Iraq. Furthermore, it is reported that Yunis' organization is focused on securing political rehabilitation, amnesties and the repatriation of Ba'athist exiles, unlike the Naqshbandi army which wants to violently overthrow the Iraqi government. According to the United States Department of the Treasury, Yunis has lived back and forth between Syria, Iraq and the United Arab Emirates. On the 23rd of August 2009, the Iraqi government aired a tape of an alleged conversation between two members of the Syria-based Iraqi Ba'athist movement, Saddam Farhan and al-Ahmed, linking them with the August 2009 Baghdad bombings which claimed more than 100 lives. The Syrian Foreign Ministry denied Syrian involvement in the attack. On the 25th of August, Iraq summoned its ambassador to return from Syria. The Syrian government issued a similar order to its ambassador within hours in retaliation. When the Iraqi government demanded in November 2009 that Syria extradite al-Ahmed, President al-Assad refused to do so, claiming that he had already been expelled from Syria. Despite this, Iraqi and American security forces had reported no signs of Ba'athists illegally crossing the border in the recent months, and responsibility for the August bombings was later claimed by the Islamic State of Iraq. Ba'athist rivalries. Ahmed was first mentioned in a report in the Iraqi government-owned Al-Sabah newspaper, which reported on the 6th of December 2004 that a captured insurgent, Moyyed Yassin Ahmed, the leader of Jaish Muhammad, had claimed that Ahmed had recently been elected secretary of the Iraqi Ba'ath party at a conference held by a group of Ba'athist fugitives in Al-Hasuka, Syria. Ahmed made another attempt for the party leadership following the death of Saddam Hussein, leading to condemnation from supporters of al-Duhuri who ordered the expulsion of Ahmed and 150 other members of the party. Ahmed issued a counter-order ordering the expulsion of al-Duhuri from the party, leading to the creation of two separate wings of the Iraqi Ba'ath party. Al-Duri issued a statement criticizing Syria and Youyunis for what Al-Duri claimed was an American-supported attempt to undermine the Iraqi Ba'athist party, although this statement was later downplayed. Ahmed's wing of the party allegedly has contacts with former Republican Guard Commander Riad al-Hamdani, and has also allegedly been in contact with Wafiq al-Samri in an effort to legitimize the party. Ahmed, in his attempts to reunite the party, and built a close working relationship with the Syrian government, unlike al-Duri, who distrusts the Syrians due to their alliance with the Iranians. The Syrian government is quietly supporting Ahmed in order to gain more control over the Iraqi Ba'athist party. In March 2009, several members representing Youyunis approached coalition forces and the provincial reconstruction team in Saladin Governorate. They met with representatives of the coalition, instead of representatives of the Iraqi government, because they claimed the Iraqi government was under Iranian influence, and might seek revenge against any Ba'athist party members. They said that the Youyunis-led faction were dissatisfied with the present government of Iraq, which they claimed was both sectarian and also failing to provide infrastructure and public services. The representatives claimed that the Youyunis-led faction wasn't opposed to democracy, and instead wished to peacefully participate in the democratic process. They also claimed that unlike the al-Duri-led faction, they recognized that the pre-2003 Ba'athist government had made many mistakes, and that Iraq could not return to that system of government. Ahmed's attempts to recruit support in Syria from former Iraqi Ba'athists is meeting some success, particularly among the poorer Sunni Arab segment of the refugee population, due in part to Ahmed's ability to offer cash incentives and Syrian residency permits due to their closeness to the Syrian government. See also list of fugitives from justice who disappeared. Notes. References. Works cited: Cordis Mann, Anthony H., Beatger, Patrick, 2006. Iraqi Security Forces: A Strategy for Success. Westport, London. Prieger. Hafez, Mohammed M., 2007. Suicide Bombers in Iraq: The Strategy and Ideology of Martyrdom. Washington, D.C., United States Institute of Peace. ISBN 978-1601270047. Weiss, Michael, Hassan, 2016, First Pub. 2015. ISIS: Inside the Army of Terror, 2nd ed. London, New York City, Reagan Arts. ISBN 978-1941393574.